Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. I'm saddened we cannot be together to worship and give thanks this day, but COVID has intervened in our lives in so many ways, and this is just one of them. But I have joy in knowing that you are safe and that we can gather in this format and give thanks. As you safely gather this Thanksgiving, I do want you to give thanks for all we have and all we share. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And blessed be God's kingdom now and forever. The Lord be with you and also with you. Let us pray. Almighty and gracious Father, we give thanks for the fruits of the earth in their season and for the labors of those who have harvested them. Make us, we pray, faithful stewards of your great bounty for the provision of our necessities and the relief of all who are in need to the glory of your name through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Thanksgiving prayers of the people. The response is, we thank you, Lord. Let us give thanks to God our Father for all his gifts so freely bestowed upon us, for the beauty and wonder of your creation in earth and sky and sea. We thank you, Lord, for all that is gracious in the lives of men and women, revealing the image of Christ. We thank you, Lord, for our daily food and drink, our homes and families, and our friends.
We thank you,
Lord, for minds to think and hearts to love and hands to serve.
We thank you, Lord,
for health and strength to work and leisure to rest and play.
We thank you, Lord,
for the brave and courageous who are patient in suffering and faithful in adversity.
We thank you, Lord,
for all valiant seekers after truth, liberty, and justice.
We thank you, Lord,
for the communion of saints in all times and places.
We thank you, Lord,
above all, we give you thanks for the great mercies and promises given to us in Christ Jesus our Lord. To him be praise and glory with you, O Father, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Psalm 100. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is God that made us, and we are God's. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him, bless his name. For the Lord is good, his steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I was reminded this week about the factual way Thanksgiving has arrived and has now moved forward to 2020. Usually when we celebrate Thanksgiving, we think about 1621 and the pilgrim leader William Branford, who proclaimed a day of feasting to commemorate the first harvest after a long, long year of suffering. What you may not know is that the colonies, as they grew and became more prosperous, forgot all about Thanksgiving and the meaning it held. And for generations, Thanksgiving was celebrated sporadically on no set date. Then in 1822, Sarah Hale, a young widow from New Hampshire, decided to revive this important celebration. Sarah, the mother of five children, and an editor of a woman's magazine, began her 40-year campaign, writing editorials, letters, to governors and presidents to get Thanksgiving officially recognized. Three presidents turned her down, but her obsession became a reality in 1863 when President Abraham Lincoln proclaimed the last Thursday of November as an annual celebration of Thanksgiving. Well, we know in 1863, things were topsy-turvy for Lincoln, yet he visioned for his nation this Thanksgiving as something special. And so here we are today to celebrate that holiday. As the psalm said today, make a joyful noise. Enter in God's court with thanksgiving and praise. I asked a few of my friends, clergy and lay, about how we should proclaim Thanksgiving. There is something healthy about Thanksgiving, someone said. However, he didn't say it was the meals, only the day. We might overindulge on Thanksgiving. That's what we do, isn't it? There's something traditional about that and our Thanksgiving meal. But as we gather for the meal, whether we are one or two or four, let us remember those things we are thankful for. It helps us to realize we should live our lives in such a way that we're giving thanks every day. It could be grace with meals, it might be at a prayer time, but giving thanks helps us understand what it means to be a Christian. Therefore, we can make a joyful noise and worship the Lord with gladness and singing. Someone else said to me, giving thanks reminds us of how blessed we are. Someone anonymous wrote this. If you woke up this morning and were able to hear the birds sing, your vocal cords could utter sounds, walk to the breakfast table, read a newspaper and watch TV with good eyes, you are more blessed than millions of people who cannot do these simple things. If you have never experienced danger of battle or loneliness of imprisonment or the agony of torture or the pangs of starvation, you are ahead of 7 million people in the world. If you can attend church meeting without fear of harassment, arrest, or torture, or death, you are more blessed than 3 billion people in the world. If you have food in your refrigerator, clothes on your back, a roof over your head, a place to sleep, you are richer than 75% of this world. If you have money in the bank, in your wallet, spare change, in some dish somewhere, you are among the top 8% of the world wealthy. If you hold up your head with a smile on your face and are truly thankful, you are blessed because of the majority of the world can, but most do not. End quote. Giving thanks truly reminds us about how blessed we are. This is not to say you and I don't have problems. We do. But even in the midst of COVID and our problems, most of us, our blessings far outweigh our burdens. Make a joyful noise and come into God's presence. Someone else said to me, giving thanks also reminds us about the source of our blessings. It reminds us about how much God loves us. When we start counting our blessings, something similar to what Bing Crosby sings about counting our blessings instead of sheep, we are reminded just how good God has been to us. After all, these blessings just don't happen. They're the source of everything we have. I once read a professor of chemistry said to a student one day, a seminary student, you know what holds an atom together? It's not the nucleus, but an invisible force between the protons and the electrons. The professor continued, I think this has something to do with religion, but I don't know how to express it. The end of the quote. Well, professor, let me tell you, there is a God creator. He created us all and every wondrous gift we have. When we give thanks, we are reminded of the source of everything. Psalm 100 says, "Know that the Lord is God. It is God that made us, and we are God's people and the sheep of his pasture." Knowing this, we can make joyful noises and come into God's presence. When we give thanks, we are reminded to share this with others, what the Lord has done for us. If you are truly thankful for the blessings of God that has been bestowed upon you, then share your story with others. Of course, the best way to share the story is to share the blessings and God's love. You and I have been blessed. We need Thanksgiving to remind us of those blessings and to remind us of the source of those blessings. We now go forth and enjoy our Thanksgiving meal. Whether we are in person or we are on Zoom, remember all that the Lord has given us and give thanks. Amen. Let us now pray those words that Jesus taught us to pray by saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." And now the blessing. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. And now let the weak say, "I am strong," and the poor say, "I am rich," because of what the Lord has done. Give thanks. In the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you this day and remain with you always. Amen. Happy Thanksgiving.